Sustainability. Everyone talks about it, but sometimes we hear so much information from many sides that we may not know what is true and what's not. We will help you to understand what can be the right approach. Let us introduce Visegrad University partners of the program. Each of them will explain their perspective and the current situation in their country, and also give you important advices. Where do we stand? What we can do? The change is now. We are the change. Let's get the insights on sustainable approach from all V4 countries.
Slow fashion, it's a one important part of the fashion, and it's great studying and thinking with the students what is the future of there, what is the future of the design, and what is the future of the Czech design. And I think that now it's happened that we absolutely changed the meaning of this problematic, because when you don't, if you don't go to the shop and buy something, so now it's a time for the thinking about the regional fashion, regional work, and slow fashion. We made one project together. It was the slow fashion, and it was the zero impact. And it was very interesting for us, because we first time collaborate with another university in the very interesting and important project. And the students start thinking different about the zero waste, about the zero cut, about the natural materials. And I think that thanks to this project, we start open the new program in our faculty, start teaching the slow fashion program. I think that now you can see how the small label it's stronger and great for us. You can see how the big market of fast fashion are a little bit slow, because they are closed, they don't possible to do the market. And the small company and small labels are more creative, and it's super that they still in the great help for the people in the street or on the countries. This is very important. Small labels, it's great.
Kto podľa vás môže motivovať alebo začať takúto pozitívnu zmenu v produkcii a spotrebe? Myslím, že to môže byť v podstate hocikto, kto skutočne chce. Spotrebiteľ, ktorý svojim nákupom podporí udržateľný produkt, výrobca, ktorému bude záležať na tom, akú environmentálnu stopu po sebe zanechá, dizajner, ktorý navrhne udržateľný produkt, alebo pedagóg, ktorý svojim študentom objasní základnú problematiku udržateľnej módy, prípadne rodič, ktorý naučí svoje dieťa ekologicky myslieť.
Hello, I am really happy to participate at the European Fashion Accelerator program. My name is Adrienne Nagy. I am an assistant professor of the Molina University of Art and Design Topes. I work at the textile department. Sustainability is a very important question of our lifetime. But we can see clearly that the mechanism of the international fashion industry doesn't work any longer. Fast fashion, overconsumption, greenwashing, upcycling, recycling, downcycling. These are just a few of the definitions that popped up during the last decades. Fashion has been rated as the most polluting industry in the world. For example, fast fashion is putting our future planet at risk, as we know that. I think COVID-19 just the beginning of something new. There will be a lot of changes financially as well. It's almost unpredictable what will happen, but I think a lot of customers and companies have to be savvier than before. Rosina Pustai finished her BA program in 2020. Her research focused on sustainability and overconsumption in the fashion industry.
Udržitelné módě se věnuju 4 roky, s tím, že první 2 roky jsem byla spíš cíleně zaměřená na nějakou kritiku, na nadměrnou produkci a zaměřená na vlastně plýtvání zdrojema. Nicméně poté jsem se naučila nebo dozvěděla tolik faktů, že jsem si řekla, pojďme to udělat jinak. Pojďme zkusit udělat, založit značku nebo řídit se tím, co jsem vlastně kritizovala. Takže jsem se rozhodla, že začnu na poli udržitelné módy a vlastně začnu od začátku. To znamená, že vlastně ta kolekce spočívá na udržitelných látkách přírodního původu, které jsou certifikovaných zdrojů. Snažím se využívat co nejvíc lokálních tvůrců, takže používám český len nebo bambusovo-konopný flíz, který je vyráben právě v České republice. A co se týče vlastně té tvorby, tak se snažím vlastně tvořit i zero waste smyslem, což znamená, že je co nejmíň odpadu při tvorbě střihu. Ta věc nebo oblast té pomalé módy se týká většinou mladých lidí, což je ale dobře, protože mladí lidé vlastně určují tu poptávku. Takže já doufám, že to všechno bude dobré a bude se to jenom zlepšovat. U udržitelné módy je také důležitá samotná prezentace a distribuce těch výrobků. Přece jenom logistické služby a balící služby je součást udržitelné módy, protože se jedná vlastně o celý cyklus. Takže třeba v rámci mojí značky to se snažím řešit tak, že vlastně i samotná ramínka, která jsou většinou právě plastová nebo kovová s různými úchyty, tak se snažím řešit takovou jednoduchou formou vlastně ramínka, které slouží zároveň i jako vizuál.
For the young designers and for young brands, it's kind of easy to become a local producer, and it's kind of a push you to produce your collections locally because you don't have much money to source them, and you don't have much money to buy expensive fabrics from Asia, for example, because you always want to avoid tax, etc., etc. So it's kind of integral part of your brand DNA if you're a young designer that you are kind of sustainable from scratch because you produce mostly everything locally and you try to buy fabrics also locally to reduce transportation costs, etc., etc. So it's easier and more difficult at the same time because you know it's always the question of balance between the costs and the revenues, which are low and costs are high. So I guess it's just an effort which you have to put into your business when you started and to support yourself, to support the industry, sustainable industry, and to support local tailoring studios, local masters, and that all comes together. The main approach, I guess, is just to be reasonable, you know, in everything you do. And weigh all pros and cons and to find the best way to remain sustainable yet still aiming to be profitable as a young designer again. And so yeah, you just need to spend more time and more effort to find better ways to source the fabrics, to find the better local producers, to make it on time and of high quality, you know, to win over the customers, but still to be truthful to your commitment, you know, to remain sustainable. So that's the only way. Like more effort, more time, more commitment, and that will do.
Many creative and exceptional people come from Central Europe. This program is cooperation of 4 strong countries with very strong connection. And me, myself, I come from Prague, from heart of Europe. And I see so many exceptional and talented people around me. And we are here for many years now to discover the best talents from Central Europe for the global fashion market.